Okay, let's talk about basic workflows in Zoho CRM. Go to Setup. Automation Workflow Rules. Create a rule. Create it on the Leads module. And we'll do Field Update for Leads. We'll do on a record action. We've got a couple of options. I'm going to start off by looking at the scenario where you want to trigger a workflow when someone ticks the box called Add Call Log. So we've got a field update and we're doing Add Call Log. We'll make it so that only records matching the condition that Add Call Log is selected. And then we have the choice between executing it every time the record is edited or just the first time. I'm going to go every time, because that's more fun. Then we have instant actions. We can send an email, create a task, do a field update, call a webhook and a custom function. Webhooks and custom functions are out of the scope of this video. We're just talking about basic workflows here. If we want to send an email, we choose that option, and then you can either create a new alert where you are able to select the relevant template, choose where the email should go, email the lead in this case, put any additional recipients, put myself, and then save and associate. Easy as that. If we want to add a task, pretty similar process. We choose the due date. We can make it so that the due date is based on a couple of possible dates. We can do the created time, modified time, last activity time. Workflow rule trigger date is probably the most likely case. And we'd probably do something like plus 7 days. Now, when we are setting up the subject of the task, we can put in some merge fields. So, for example, if I want to make it include the lead ID, I don't know why I'd want to do that, but we can do that in the task subject. Or more likely, we'd probably do name. After that, we can choose who it will be assigned to. If you leave it blank, it'll be assigned to the record owner. And we can choose to notify and remind the assignee if required. Then we just save and associate. Bingo, that's done. Field update. Create a new field update. Why not? Let's make add call log unticked after it gets ticked. I can either select it or deselect it. I'm gonna deselect it in this case. That's pretty much what you do. You can do a little bit with basic workflows. You have got other options as well. You can do it on a date time. That can be handy. What I sometimes do is I'll have a date field in my record, for example, contract start date. And I might, one thing that I've done in the past is if I want to look at a lead regularly, I can set it up so that there'll be a field called next touch point, which is a date, And then the workflow will be triggered on that date. Do on contract start date, put it at, I don't know, 7 a.m. bright and early. And then what you can do, you can set it up using a field update to again update next contact date to be the execution day plus 14 days. In that way, you could set up a workflow so that every 14 days you would get a task, a reminder to contact a certain lead. Many things are possible. You've got a variety of different options in terms of the kind of triggers. We've talked about date time, we've talked about field update. You can also do create or edit, which will be triggered anytime the record gets touched, or on delete. And again, with the criteria, you can either do all records, or you can have multiple criteria. You can also choose between and or. For example, you might want to do if either add call log is selected or the city is Timbuktu. Don't know if that's how you spell it, but that is a potential criteria that you could use. Hopefully that gives you a sense of what is possible in a simple way with workflows. If you want to touch on the more advanced parts, we'll cover that in another video.